everyone. Just to warn you, I am a bit of a crier, so I'm going to try to get through this. It's safe to say that I was lost prior to trusting Christ. Through most of my younger years, I attended a Lutheran church with my family. Until my early teens, I was what I would consider a public Christian. I attended weekly Bible classes, completed confirmation, and would go on any youth church trip that I could. I did all of the things that my church friends did, but rarely ever did I pray or even try to follow God's commands. I had so many doubts and questions that I was either too embarrassed or afraid to ask, and instead of sitting in those doubts, I just gave up on my faith altogether. Instead, I convinced myself that if I was a good person and was helpful towards others, that I would probably get to heaven. Around 13 or 14, I started my battle with depression. Aside from some hazing at school, I grew up with a very fortunate life. Close, loving family, and support in any kind of endeavor I would try. Not having a proper perspective of God, I blamed my constant feelings of sadness on him and even began to mock him. Things quickly got worse as I strayed to almost anything that would give me temporary comfort. It took 2 stays at a youth mental facility to learn how to cope with my thoughts and feelings. By my early 20s, I was making the best of my situation and putting all of my energy towards climbing up the corporate ladder. I soon after met my husband of 12 years, Josh, and had our one son, Tommy. After giving birth, I realized there was no other way that such a perfect little creation could happen other than to be made by God. I slowly but silently started opening my mind to him, but all of those questions and doubts would rise again. As far as what led me to be saved, my how was actually the opposite of what normal steps would be. I knew that I didn't want my child in the school district that we live in, so my husband and I decided to enroll him in a Christian school that was recommended to us. I thought I had my faith at the time. Being taught about God as a child, I thought because I knew about God that I still believed in him. I started getting to know some of the other moms, and one of them, Emily, invited me to attend the church with her and her family. So that Sunday, my family joined Emily's at the service. It was Pastor Pat, and he was preaching like no one I've ever heard before. I listened to his sermon and took in the gospel, and I knew right away that this church was going to help give me the answers to so many of my questions. Shortly after, I started meeting with Lori and began to study the Bible with her help. In my studies, I learned how many sins I was guilty of. As Romans 14:23 says, "For whatever does not proceed from faith is sin." This completely changed my perspective on what I was doing. Practically minute by minute, it shook me. I'm not only a sinner, but a constant sinner. Very few things that I was doing would please God. I thought maybe all of these good deeds that I had done surely had to help my position. But then I heard Isaiah 64:6. "We are all infected and impure with sin. When we display our righteous deeds, they are nothing but filthy rags. Like autumn leaves, we wither and fall, and our sins sweep us away like the wind." Then I learned verse by verse how through his death, burial, and resurrection, God sent his son to save us all for our sins, even me. It sounded too easy for us, which we all know life isn't normally this way. Lori asked me after this if I thought I was saved, and I couldn't answer with a yes. I realized I needed to see proof, facts, evidence that this really happened, that it wasn't just a story. Yet I felt it would be almost disrespectful to turn to technology and Google it, as it felt like cheating. The inability to believe it was ultimately what had led me back for so many years, and I was finally facing it head on. Then early morning on November 10th of last year, after dropping my son off at school, I was driving home with the same conviction on my mind. I told myself I would research to try to find something irrefutable that proves that it is all true. Then it hit me, how many people believed and blindly lived for Christ before he was even born, let alone after? Why do I need more? I started crying enough that I had to pull over into the nearby church parking lot. I prayed to the Lord that I do believe in him, how sorry I was for all of my sins, including resisting my belief, and thanked him for sending his son to save me. Even in this time, since coming to believe and trust in Christ, my life has changed in more ways than I can count. I'm now able to realize what things are worth focusing my attention on. Things outside of God's glory are not as appealing anymore. It took longer than I'd like to admit, but now I'm excited about opening my Bible each day and learning more through his words. Since coming into faith, I have had some hardships that could normally send me into several more spirals of depression. But instead of my depression, I feel hope and joy and love. So much love from my God, for he made us in his image and he sent us our salvation. Like Zephaniah 3:17, For the Lord your God is living among you. He is a mighty Savior. He will take delight in you with gladness. With his love, he will calm all your fears. He will rejoice over you with joyful songs. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
All right, let's pray for Missy. God, we do praise you for the work that you have done and continue to do in Missy's life. From depression to delight in you, we praise you for the work that you have done in her life. We pray, God, that as she continues to seek to become more like your son, Jesus Christ, that she would continue to dive into your word, that you would grow in her. Her relationship with you would grow for the rest of her life, and that she would be a light and an impact to those around her as well. We pray all these things in your son's name. Amen. All right, Missy, go ahead and turn right here.
Okay.
All right. Grab right there. Yep. All right. It is my joy and privilege upon your profession of faith to baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.